you don't find God in a noisy place. You know, God's voice is silence. You know, and you know, going within and getting quiet and getting peaceful. You know, it's just, you know, it's the silence. They say it's the silence between the notes that makes the music. You know, it's not the noise.
Yeah. So living in Hawaii then, and for you, and what I found fascinating about our last conversation is the fact that you have no computer.
No, I don't have a, I've never had a computer.
And so you're not
I have
connected.
No email. I've never had an email. I get thousands of them at the publisher's house, but I don't do that. I write by hand.
So do people still write you correspondence then? Do people who follow you? Because
yeah.
I know you have so many fans. So many people who really listen to your guidance and they write to you the old-fashioned way.
Yeah, I just get letters.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, that's the way I, it's, to me, a machine just gets in the way. It gets in between myself and what I'm trying to do. So for me, it doesn't work. Even I used to write on a typewriter, but even that I find, you know, intrusive.
Well, and loud. Again, you know, talking about a noisy world, they were definitely a lot louder than
they sure were.
What we're dealing with now.
Yeah.
Do you ever feel uncomfortable with the level that people put you at? I mean, because I know that people look up to you so much.
I don't feel uncomfortable with it. I feel, I'm surprised by the, I'm surprised by it because it's the exact opposite of what I teach. Mm-hmm. You know, it's like I teach that you know you are the guru and that you know that nobody is any better than anybody else, including me. I'm surprised, I guess, by the amount of love that I get everywhere I go. I mean, my audiences and my mail and just going for walks or whatever it is, people are they exhibit a great deal of love for me. I think it's because I probably brought some element of healing or peace or happiness into their lives, and they attribute it to me through my writing and through my work. But I don't really. I practice humility and radical humility. Really, I don't take credit for anybody's happiness or success in life because I don't want to take blame for their unhappiness.
That's a good point. And I love the way that you've looked into so many different teachings from so many different places to help spread the message that, you know, it's so clear in everything that you write. And yet, even I who read it all the time, and I remind myself to read your work all the time, I forget, like on a daily basis sometimes.
Oh, I do too. I do too.
So
I slip all the time, and I have to remind myself to not get frustrated. Don't get on, you know, don't take it out on other people. Keep calm. You know, one of the things that helps me do that is the fact that I'm a celebrity. I can't be screwing up out there in public and have people say, look at what he teaches and look at how he acts. I try to walk the talk as much as I possibly can.
As a leader, which you are, when you see other leaders who are taking, you know, sort of an opposite stance to the way that you live your life and dealing with peace and that, does it get frustrating for you?
Yeah, it does. I mean, I was just looking at the paper this morning, and I just saw that Bank of America has decided that they're going to, because they have a legal right to do so, they're going to continue with these foreclosures, you know, even though they're being asked to stop that because, you know, they've got 100,000 more that they're going to do, and every one of those are families being put out on the street, and I'm always surprised at the lack of kindness toward each other, you know, our inhumanity to each other, not just, you know, the people who look a little bit different and live in different parts of the world that we go out there to kill, which I think is just horrific, but the just the ways that we treat each other, the way governments treat their employees, the way their subjects, rather, and the way businesses treat their customers and so on. What's in it for me? How much more can I get? What I'm going to do to you because I have a legal right to do it. Instead of looking within and finding compassion and kindness and extending that in our business practices, I've tried to run my business on that way, and I really believe you can run a very successful and profitable business by being more concerned about the people that you care about and helping them and instead of seeing how much you can screw them.
No, you know what? I think that you're absolutely right. In fact, I work the radio station is owned by a billionaire. He's one of the wealthiest men in Canada, probably in the top three. And I was just speaking with him the other day, and his whole entire, he's 82 years old. He's just fantastic. His whole entire belief system was based on the fact that each of us, no matter where we are in our lives, our thoughts and our goals and our dreams are just as important as, say, Oprah, who is his friend, you know, or,
yeah, absolutely,
or Barack
yes.
Obama.
And yeah, the fact that we need to, it's a new paradigm that we're going to have to fix. If we don't fix it, you know, I don't think that our world can survive. We have to start treating each other. We're at a point now where the lowest among us, you know, have the opportunity. When I say the lowest, I mean those who are the poorest and have the least recognition and so on, have the option of organizing and literally ending the world. I mean, getting their hands on nuclear weapons, the people like the Taliban and so on. We can no longer just continue to treat people without a lack of respect and dignity. I think the survival of the whole place is at hand. You know, Mother Teresa once said that every day, I see Jesus Christ in all of his distressing disguises. We have to find the Christ light and the God consciousness in everyone and begin to treat people that way. Otherwise, I don't think humanity will survive.